Hello, hello everyone, Ryan from Avatar Aquatics. Welcome to another video. Today we're focused purely on the development of the Cardinal Tetras. So if you haven't seen my breeding videos, I've linked it up in the right hand, top right hand corner, as well as down in the description below. Be sure to check that out once you're done watching this video. What you see here is a 4 week old fry, and that's when their blue stripes really come in. It's a beautiful fish, but let's just rewind a little bit and start with when the eggs are laid. So the adults like to lay their eggs in the spawning media as well as down in the peat moss. Now, whenever they swim around, the peat moss gets kicked up and the eggs are buried into the peat moss. It's an excellent way of hiding the eggs because, be warned, the adults will definitely eat the eggs if they find them. I like to remove the adults after they spawned and just try to isolate the eggs like I've done here in this little cup. In the middle, you see all those little light brown shapes in the center of the screen, and that's actually the eggs themselves. I use a little bit of methylene blue to stop it from fungusing over, and just let them incubate there. This video was taken about 4 to 5 hours after the eggs are laid, and already we see a lot of development already happening here. These two are fertile eggs, and within about 16 to 20 hours after the eggs are laid, the fry actually start hatching out, so their development is actually really, really fast. The night of the spawning, if you take a flashlight and sweep it over the peat moss, you'll see these tiny little white opaque things swimming along the peat moss, and those are actually the fry themselves, newly hatched out. Now, I apologize for the graininess of this video. It was dark, but I promise the rest of the video has really incredible, detailed, and clear footage. So, if you isolate these fry, this is what they look like. Now, the blue water is from the methylene blue, but as you'll see, they're actually very, very underdeveloped at this stage of hatching out, and the most that you can see is really just their very large tummy with the egg yolk in them. This is what they look like under the microscope. You see that big section in the center of them is all just yolk, but do not be fooled. These guys can and will react to light and movement in the water. Now, I've never noticed that these guys are photosensitive at all, so don't be afraid of shining flashlights or keeping these guys in the light. I don't know where the claim came from that the fry and eggs are photosensitive, but that is not the case for what I've found. So right here is a 2-day-old fry. You can see a lot more detail has already developed. You can see their brain, their eyes, as well as the little heart right in front of their yolk sac. And then also the tail, the muscles, and the vertebrae have really developed. And if you look really closely, you can actually start to see the beginning and the end of their digestive tract. At 4 days old, these guys have already developed their GI tract and are almost done with their yolk sac. You can also see that their eyes have now started turning black and there's a lot more color to the fry. Now at this stage, they're almost ready to start hunting for microorganisms and food. The first week of development, the fry really cannot swim really well. It's super cute seeing them struggle along the bottom of the grow out tank. And you'll see that right in the center of the screen. And that guy is a little bit lopsided. You could kind of tell he's trying to swim, but he can't really swim well. Now, do not worry. These guys are not sick or dying. This is just the way these guys are. So the first week or so, it's actually really funny just watching them trying to learn how to swim. I love seeing this in the middle of the night when I come check up on them. Here's a video of a little bit more fry, and they're all trying to learn how to swim. I think this is just the most adorable thing in the world. You can kind of see them kind of swim in little spurts, but these guys aren't really ready to swim yet. Now, right in the center of the screen right here, you see a little bit bigger fry, and this guy I would say is about 1 week to maybe 1.5. Now, you'll see here that in the center of the screen, this fry is still too small for baby brine shrimp. So all the way up until around the 2nd week of their development, you really want to make sure that you're feeding infusoria because that is the only food small enough for them. So that big one you see here, these two big ones in the front are around 2 weeks old, and at this point they can swim quite well and they can hunt infusoria. Now remember, you must also prepare baby brine shrimp, because starting from week 3, baby brine shrimp is going to be their main staple food, and then you should supplement with the infusoria. I just love watching these guys zoom around the bottom of the tank. I've definitely noticed that these guys are way more active at night, whereas in the day, they actually just kind of hide among the moss and the filter and rarely make an appearance, even if I go right down there and shine a light on them. Perhaps that's where the photosensitive claim came out, but just to be sure, although the eggs require sort of low light, dim light to be laid, and the cardinal tetras spawn in low light, the fry will not be negatively impacted if you have a light. So over here, you actually see a 3-week-old fry. Now this guy, I just turned the light on, he's a little bit dazed, but as you can see, the belly is full of orange baby brine shrimp. This guy is 3 weeks old and almost ready to start growing in his stripes. Now this is the beginning of week 3. At the end of week 3, you're going to see a lot more development. Now this is somewhere in the middle of week 3, and you can see that this fry here has now started to have his fins change into the shape of a cardinal tetra. This guy is hunting, he's really, really fed well, he's fat, and most of what he's eating now will be baby brine shrimp. So this guy should be what you see in the middle of week 3. At the beginning of week 4, we start to see the beautiful blue stripe come in. It starts at the eyes and gradually grows towards the tail. Now that belly is full of baby brine shrimp, and behind him you can actually see in the depth another younger week 3 fry. So at this stage, they're surviving purely on baby brine shrimp, and that electric blue stripe will only get more prominent and only get more stronger. At the middle of week 4, this is what we see. The stripe has already come in now, and these guys are much more active. They're actively exploring the bottom, looking for microworms, for baby brine shrimp, and these guys are what you see at the very beginning of this video. Look at him. He's like not afraid of me anymore. He's just chilling along the glass, and this is when you start feeling such an immense proud feeling for having raised these baby cardinal tetras. Now at this stage, I like to keep them in there for until the end of week 4 and transfer them to another step like here. So this one is actually week 5, and the red of the cardinal tetra has already come in. Now thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed this footage. If you liked it, give me a like, thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.